All right, so with the panda, when I do the circles on characters like this, oh, this is too big, it's going to take forever to color in, it's all right. I try to do them a little bit wider than they are tall. Kind of like a fatter head. It just kind of makes them look friendlier.
You don't ride an elevator for the music, and you don't pick an airline for the movies. So when it comes to audio entertainment, it makes sense to choose Audible.
And let's see, we'll do the nose. I like to do just a triangle, but it's kind of round on the sides. I think the trick to doing a panda is the eyes here. They kind of droop down. I don't know, maybe a little bit bigger. And it's not until you color it that it actually looks like a panda. We'll make him a little... Maybe he's a little sad or something. And I make the body real small. So this is going to be the little white... patch. Maybe he's raising his arm. And... try to keep the legs short. Yeah, kind of some sad body language there. But I always draw them the same way every time, so try to switch it up a little bit. Were you always good at drawing? No. There was a point where I was just... you know, like the average kid. I think what happened about the second grade, I started noticing I was a little bit better than the other kids, and because of that, I got encouragement from my teacher, and then the more encouragement I got, the more I drew. The more I drew, like anything else, the more you practice, the better you get. So, just kind of took off. I really believe it. My grandfather was an artist, kind of amateur. My older brother was, you know, a little bit better than average, and I think it's just all... what you're interested in. If you're interested in it more, you're naturally gonna do it more, and the more you do it, the better you get, and so on. So I just had more of an interest in it than I guess most kids. So I got better and better. I actually won my first best of show this year, in this local juried show I do every year. I was really excited. It was a colored pencil piece. I don't know if you guys saw it. It was the big lion, and I was really thrilled to get best of show because it's usually an oil or a watercolor painting. Colored pencils are kind of like the redheaded stepchild of juried shows. You don't really see them getting best of show very often, and my dad happened to be in town and got to be there for when I found out I won best of show. It was really cool. There's a video showing him, and he got a little teary-eyed. He thinks I'm a famous artist, a famous award-winning artist at that. So it was really cool for him to see it. And this pen, I know you guys are going to ask, it's a Tombow. It's a water-based felt tip pen with a brush tip. So this area is going to be white. And I'm going to leave a little bit of a white strip right there so you can see the difference from the leg to the arm. Just to create some separation. I swear pandas are the easiest. You don't really have to put any toes or feet or anything like that. As long as you color it the right way, it always looks like a cool little panda. Or a little sad panda. This one looks like he's sad, like he needs to use the restroom. Or maybe he already did and needs to go change his panda pants. Now I'll switch to my smaller pen. What's up, Jarrett? It's my nephew, Jarrett. He's in in Alabama. Now I'm going to do, I'm not going to draw these little lines. I'm going to do like this. It's going to show his eyebrows like he's sad. And then a little bit over the top of the nose, because that top white part, that's kind of just the highlight of it, where the light's hitting it. This pen's drying out. Actually, I could do like that. Now I just add the little, some hair. He's had a rough day. The cool part, once you get this done, I'll show you another little trick I like to do with the pencils. Just to make them, I do it on all, oh, I forgot the eyes, so. There we go. Has Thunder Buddy vibe. So the cool thing about using these felt tip pens, if you used a ballpoint pen, you're going to smear this when you go to erase. You can see I just did this a second ago, and I can go and erase and not smear that ink. So grab yourself some felt tip pens. They dry super quick. Because if you've tried to do this, you know the headache of smearing, and I almost did there a little bit. Now what I like to do is add just a tiny bit of shading on the bottom parts, and I'll use my little cheater stick or my blending stump, and it'll give it a little bit of dimension and depth. This is a blending stump or a tortillion blending stump, cheater stick, whatever you want to call it. I'll do a little bit around his nose too. And then down here, so you can see that he's standing on the ground. These little shadows, I could have just left them alone and it would have been fine, but when you do these little shadows, it does make a difference. And it doesn't take much. Just do some little squiggly marks and blend it together with a blending stump. And there you go. He's a little bit of an angle. Looks like he's on a hill. There we go. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time. Make sure to hit that bell so you get alerts every time I post a new video. And make sure to subscribe and follow me on TikTok and Instagram. We'll see you next time.